Some businesses dependent on recurring tasks. For example, this is a demo of an accounting firm. And let's assume that every month I supposed to run payroll, I supposed to run taxes for my clients. So every Steven, let's convert him. He's right now a lead. Let's convert him into a customer. Okay. Okay. So I have Steven. Steven is a customer. He's not really a customer, right? Allegedly is a customer. And right now, I will create a project for Steven, because Steven likes me to run payroll for him. So I will go to the projects area. Let's go here, it will be faster. And I will create a new project. Project name will be payroll. It will start today. And because he paid me for 1 year, I will make it until next year. And that's it. Now, as you can see, the client user is Steven Colbert, which means he can see and have access to all my external tasks. There are internal tasks that only my team can see, and there are external tasks that Steven can have access to. So let's save it. Okay, the project is open. Now let's go to the project and let's create a recurring task. And the recurring task will be that my employees will get once a month a task that they're supposed to run payroll for Steven. So let's go to tasks. I will create a simple task, run payroll. Please go to QuickBooks and run payroll. Okay. And the user will be, let's say myself. It will start today. It will end in a year. And I'm setting recurrence, which means every second, so it will be a monthly recurring, so every 1 month, and that will be for 12 time, because I got paid for 12 time. Now, in case that you like to have the task running forever, you just go all the way down and select no end time. Okay, now in case that this specific date, so the 22nd, will fall on a weekend, I can click here and then it will schedule the task to show 1 day before the weekend. And that's good for me, right? Because I'm a business and I don't work weekends. Okay. The priority will be medium. And I click add. Now I have here a task that once a month there will be a new task that will ask me to create payroll for this specific client. If I will go to my projects system and I will click view more, I can arrange what task I like to see, which usually will be what is overdue and what is for today. And then I will see all the tasks that are actually pending. For example, running the payroll for today, which that's one of the tasks. And I have to file federal tax for a different client. This is for NASCAR. Of course, they're not my client, as I said before, but it's just a demo. And also run payroll for NASCAR. So those are the three tasks that I have in the system. Whenever I will deal with them, I can click on the status or I can click on the task itself and I can have more information. For example, I can log the hours, how much time I worked for this specific job. So there's 3 hours, right? And it's billable time, which means I can produce invoices based on the billable time. I can also set activities, for example, or I can also have subtasks. So maybe running the payroll require me to grab the hours from Josh. So that will be also a small task that I need to do, and that will be for today. And now I will have also another task in the system, and you can see it's becoming a child task to run payroll. So this is really how you run recurring tasks. It's very cool. Try it out. Let me know if you have any questions.